Thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to be zhuzhing up a wire wrap that a friend gave to me. They really like what they have, but they'd like it to be a little bit more. So I chose a couple different things here. I have some ruby beryl chips, a little blue turquoise skull, a dancing bear charm, as well as eight different little hematite balls. These ones are plain hematite, then they are coated green, coated purple, and coated blue. And then I have a number of wires to pick from. I'm not sure exactly how it's going to turn out, but I got a lot of options and I'm excited. And I hope you're excited too. Let's get started. I don't have any wire cutters right now, so I am just gonna trim it with my special method. Okay, I think I like that position. I have to try to tighten it up though. I have to go through the bobby pin because he likes to clip it through a buttonhole in his denim jacket. So we still want him to be able to do that. Maybe I will go through this again. Let's leave these little bits here until I know exactly what I'm gonna do in the end. I know I wanna add this. I think the orange. Thank you. So if your wire is thin enough and you don't have any wire cutters, I found that this back and forth method actually works really well. I've already got a jump ring on the charm because I want it to have a little bit of mobility. I don't want to just wire wrap it down and have it be, you know, really sedentary. So I don't know if you saw that, but what I just did was I looped one end around the back side, one through this front. The one that went through the back came around and through the jump ring again. And now it's back here. I'm gonna try to tighten it up back there. There, finally got some leverage. Like he's backwards. Let's see if we can do this without taking him off of the whole thing. No. Okay. Much better. Okay, we'll use this orange to tighten up that blue that wasn't so fresh. also don't want to put too much wire up here. He's going to want to clip it. All right, so what I did was I had that little blue bit down here and I was wrapping this blue bit around the top and I pulled the little one up and I wrapped this big one around it twice, then curled it around towards the little skull. That's gonna finish off this blue. Okay, now we just got this orange bit. Trying so hard to grab it through this space. You know what? I'm gonna try. Perfect. Pushed it through just enough for me to grab it. Let's do it again. Instead of going all the way around with it, I'm going to see if I can get it into the hole here. Cool. I love these colored wires, but they're so easily uncolorized. Okay, that should be sturdy and stable. What to do next? I think maybe some green wire. By the way, in case you were wondering, the wire I'm using is a package of very, very small gauge wire from Bead Landing. I get mine at Michael's, usually with a coupon, so it's not very expensive. And I've collected some of these beads from different bead shops that I visited throughout the Northeast. But yeah, I think I'm gonna go with the green. See if I can make a sort of belt. Okay, I think I got that pretty tied. This is a little loose, so I want to try to weave this bit around that and the same on this side to try and stabilize it. The wire that was on here first, though, has not got a lot of lip to it. I did it. Not where I wanted it, but I did it. Okay. Let's see how many times we can do that. Look how pretty that green coil looks. Hopefully I'll be able to do this whole bit. That'll give us a nice long coil. Let's try and do some on this side now. Goodness. Doesn't want to go in at all. First one is always the hardest. This is wants to be pretty hard too. Does it keep bending the opposite way? Oof. Can't get it through that like rosy colored wire, so we'll try and finish it off here. Tighten this up. take a little purple. Okay, so what I decided to do was just kind of wrap this around the part I wanted tighter. I pushed it out a little bit more, but I'd rather it be tight. And now, I'm just gonna through the middle purple bead. Let's go under. Same thing with this one. Through the other side of the purple bead. This purple part, I'm gonna try to get through this wire. excellent coiling. I think we're almost done. Oops. Sorry about that. Alright, so with that bit, I went around in an X shape and then just kept going around and around and around until I ran out of wire and I kind of stuck it in a hole there. So hopefully it's not sticking out anywhere to catch on anything. I like it. Simple and yet kind of zhuzhed. I don't know if I should add any of the barrel. I don't think so. I don't want to overpower it. I still want you to be able to see the opal and admire the beauty of all the colors in the opal. So let me just finish up these tails I've got. Let's see, I'm gonna trim that. Try to curl it in and under. Cool. Okay. I think it's beautiful. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Till next time.